Nelson Fidele is a Congolese refugee who has lived in Uganda since 2015. He fled the Democratic Republic of Congo following the insecurities that ravaged his home country. Fidele narrated that for the past 7 years, he has moved to several countries on the African continent, hoping to find peace as a person living with albinism, only to end up being mistreated.
Security and safety. But after that, within the country, as a person with albinism, I've really faced a lot of discrimination. Even the time I was studying, I could be discriminated at school. But that never pinned me down or stopped me from getting education or what I wanted to get from school. I moved many countries, especially the eastern countries of Africa, where I was looking for peace. But then still I could not get, because the discrimination against albinism is really too high when it comes to other countries like Rwanda, Burundi, the DR Congo. So when I get in Uganda, I found it a bit inclusive.
He says he has lived in 3 different refugee settlement camps, but he has been facing a lot of hostility from fellow refugees, some of whom have even threatened to kill him. He now decided to move to Kampala, where he is renting a room.
Being to Rwamwanja refugee camp, that's where I registered. The social discrimination and the abuse was too much, and the attacks every day, I'm being attacked. I moved to Chaka in 2019. They followed me up, attacking me. I moved to Rwamwanja. To Rwamwanja also, that was the last year, even the time I could be resting or sleeping at home. I hear people knocking, other beating the door, and I can't recognize who the people are. I said, these people might really kill me or do anything wrong about me. And that's why actually I shifted from Rwamwanja to Kampala.
Fidele's story is not any different from Albert Inanahweze, a Burundian refugee now living in Nachivale refugee settlement camp. He says despite having several skills, finding a job in Uganda is almost impossible, as people see them as social misfits.
All refugees in Uganda, monthly they get 13,000. So how can you survive if you 13,000 per month when you are a person with albinism who don't have a job? People they don't give us a job because they think we are disability, we're not able.
At the camp, it is that no matter how much you are educated, we are not included to jobs opportunities. We are not respected, or we are not taken as or considered as other people, because they say that we are not normal. They say that we are disabled. They say that we cannot see far as them, and they say that we cannot really achieve.
A new report dubbed Community Perceptions Towards Persons with Albinism, carried out in 3 refugee camps, including Rwamwanja, Nachivale and Chaka 2, indicates that refugees with albinism find difficult in accessing social services such as health and education.
Umbrella in 2018 did a research, and in that research they discovered that when persons with albinism go to access social services, especially health and education, they are rejected by nature of their skin color. These people line up for long hours under the scorching sun, and yet we know that the sun affects their skin. So you find that they hesitate to access and utilize health services and prefer to stay home.
Hostility and physical violence is another challenge faced by refugees with albinism. However, the head of community policing in the Uganda Police Force assured this vulnerable group of maximum security while they live in these refugee camps.
In these settlements that we did research on, but even other settlements, they face quite a number of challenges, and security is pivotal to them. Security, in a way that people have different perceptions towards persons with albinism, that when I have a hair of this person, I'm going to get well.
And the law empowers us to protect them at the maximum. And I want to encourage you, my brother, that in case you feel you are vulnerable, you are discriminated against, please let's not make it a debate. It is an offense to be discriminated against in the laws of Uganda. And as we, the police, the law enforcement officers, we shall take it as an offense and therefore be able to ensure that justice is committed. Please don't sit back and withdraw from.
According to the report launched, there are over 160 refugees living with albinism, and these are in different camps across the country. However, the same report indicates that over 43% of the refugees with albinism are living in hiding due to fear of mistreatment by fellow refugees. Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.